Welcome, Steve Such Extraordinaire, to show us how to put together the amazing photo booth, future booth.
Well, step one, first off, get yourself a headband. It's always important. And really, I kind of broke it up into areas. I got the pieces kind of separated out, the clips, the little wire ties, the straight H brackets. And of course, you notice there's four pieces specifically that have the little outroads on it. We'll save those for later. The standard pieces, then of course, you start with your foundation. Everything consists of male and female components. So notice over here I have the male components, and yes, we can go back to kindergarten. There is something unique about the ins and the outs. Notice this is a female input, this is a male output. And so you want to start with the males together at one end. And so we'll build off of that. It gets large enough that you'll actually do it in two pieces. So we're actually going to lay this thing down in a second. So I'm going to go ahead and start with one side and begin that process. So I'm going into a female to a male. Noticing I'm mimicking the exact same thing on both sides, okay? Now I'm gonna start to lay it down because it starts to get kind of large and heavy. So I'm gonna shift these down. And more importantly, as you notice, the bottom pieces have an outroad here a little bit. So they need to be facing each other because there's gonna be these H brackets will connect at some point here in a second. Once I lay my first two pieces down, I am grabbing my special bracket here. Now, what's important about this is you want to make sure that it matches the other side as well. So here, I have to grab a different piece. Got to grab those two. Make sure you got female to male. Then I'm going to go back to my other pieces here. And believe it or not, they're going to connect right here. I may have to make a little more space to do so. What you'll notice is sometimes the piece will come apart. It's a floating piece, so it's really easy. Just bring things over and reconnect. Now, because we're indoors, I'm not going to worry so much about excessive wind conditions, but we do have some clamps that I will use just so we have safety first.
Impressive, Steve.
Thank you, Tim.
I'm sure this booth will create thousands and thousands of leads because of this video.
Let's hope so. Now we're doing the exact same thing on the other side. Now you will need to make sure you got plenty of room. So just put these bad boys together. It's nice to be in a big space. You may not always be inside a giant auditorium.
You might, like the Country Financial Club in Autzen.
Now, this is the part where people kind of get screwed up, because these will join together. So you have to make sure these top brackets here are the exact same on that side. If you put them backwards, when you bring them up, they may not match. So make sure you do kind of keep in mind how you put those in.
So do you clip it on every spot, Steve, if you're outdoors?
If I was outdoors and the weather was bad or terrain was iffy, I might, just so you don't have it fall apart. Although this thing's pretty sturdy.
Okay.
So now we're going to bring them up together to meet. But before I do that, I'm going to insert the H's on one side. This is where people usually find out if they match things up right.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hoping I did.
Yes, I'm sure you did, Steve. You are a master.
Now on these, I will clip all four, just because it is kind of a connecting point for the whole two pieces together. Despite how it looks, it's not as heavy as you might think. The key now is, now I'm just gonna pick it up. And these things move relatively easy. But now I gotta bring these two pieces together. And this is probably the hardest part of the whole put up, is to make sure these pieces go in together. Because if they don't go right, then you gotta shimmy it until it fits.
Makes sense. I've got a lot of faith in you. Unbelievable.
And then I'll just secure these, this other side, at least one pin, if you're really worried, do two. There's your frame. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to put up the green screen, and then, of course, the shimmering top that goes on top.
Shimmering top. Can't wait to see the shimmering top.
All of this is done with these wire ties.
Okay.
So it makes the job kind of easy. But believe it or not, this is probably the part that takes the longest.
I see you're kind of separating those out.
Well, I like to put them on my wrist, Tim.
Mm-hmm.
Find they're easier to work with, easier to grab. And that way, when you grab one at a time, you're not dealing with a bunch of knots. Like Christmas lights.
Mm-hmm. How many Christmas lights do you put on your house each year?
Quite a bit, actually.
I mean, Clark.
So this top piece is just a long piece. What we have to do, you can imagine, is just basically tarp it over.
Okay.
That's what we're gonna do. So you kind of look silly doing it. What I usually do is kind of take it and tuck it over. Yeah, if it works that way. Oh, maybe not.
Now I did notice that we had this amazing step stool that comes in the trailer.
It comes in handy.
Yes. But you can just step up there. There we go. Oh.
I don't ask for directions either. So.
Right. Which is why I'm making this video. For all those people who don't ask for directions. Me being one of them myself.
Kind of right here. So I usually start with my wire ties kind of with the center, the two.
Gotcha.
And then what I'll do is just slowly begin the wire tie process. My center, Tim?
Yep.
And I always start with the very top. There's two levels of this, so I'm going to start with the top. And that's all we're going to do, all the way around. Down and around. Now, once again, if you're going to be indoors, you probably don't need to do every single one of them because it's not going to go anywhere. But if you're a little anal retentive, it makes it look nicer. But this does take a while.
You did say it was longer than building the frame.
What's that?
You did say it would be longer than building the frame.
I did. And that it is.
I noticed, Steve, you're wearing a duck shirt. Are you a duck fan?
You know, Tim, I am a duck fan. Thanks for noticing.
How do you think we're going to do next season?
Well,
better than this last one?
I was convinced we were going to be national champions this year, Tim.
Yeah.
So, right.
There's a good chance of that.
Next year we'll be national champions.
Yeah, that Clemson squad, they're not very good. So they're losing a lot of players. So we definitely got a good chance.
Yeah. We have a shot.
You know, when we sponsored this Club Level originally, we were right on that cusp.
We were. So we should be able to get the sponsorship really cheap.
We should be able to bring her down a titch.
And I like to kind of, the top layer especially, I like to make sure is put on a little tighter. As you get on the sides down below, it's not as crucial to be with so many live guys.
Good news is, Steve, I charged the battery in this camcorder.
Well, that's good.
Because this does take a little while.
It does.
What's your average time that you think? 20 minutes?
You know, if you don't have any like misalignments or things kind of fall into place, 20 minutes, maybe 30. If you're new to it, it's a little intimidating, but really, once you get the hard part's getting the frame up, and once you have the frame, and this is just tedious. Having a friend comes in handy when you're at this point.
Like, so, like if I was putting down the video camera.
If you're looking at the table, I could probably keep you busy for a good 30 minutes or so.
But I'm doing such a heck of a job filming. I guess what I'll do, Steve, is pause at this moment and I will go ahead and help you.
Hey,
and, then we'll, and then we'll be
now. So now that I had some help, you can see how we're done with the top, with the,
yes.
The shiny top part.
Shiny top is on.
We did put ties all the way down. I usually don't put anything down here because it gets a little bunched up. I let it fall loose. And now the last thing we got is we're going to put the...
Looks like your help missed one right here in this corner, Steve.
Well, I'll fix that in a second.
Yeah, okay, that help. He's terrible.
And then we're going to put the green screen on this bottom rail. So as you look, it's pretty obvious. So one side says country, we want that facing away from the green screen. So whatever side you want to put it in, it's versatile to either way. But we'll use the, I'll find my center point. I'll use the old country logo for that. And we'll start that hanging process. Notice it's kind of fits right in with the...
Could you hold that up there again real quick, Steve? Because I didn't quite catch that.
Hold on a sec, Tim. Let me get my wire tie in there. I'm going to center it here, and if you look, it just kind of fits real perfect.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
Now what you may or may not know, Tim, that you'll be taking these pictures and you're able to superimpose whatever backdrop you like.
Oh, that sounds cool.
It is. It's actually quite lovely. If you work with our, with Bryce in the home office.
Bryce Kaiser. Yeah.
I have his number. It's actually on all the iPads.
Okay.
But when you're taking the pictures, one thing you can do is these may show up. So if you actually just kind of take those and just turn the other side.
Gotcha.
It makes it look less ugly. So take a moment and do that for your guests.
All right, great.
You'll be glad you did.
I like it. Now if you had a friend that was helping you, this would go
once
faster
again,
as well.
A friend comes in handy.
Uh-huh. This time he's just going to hold the camera because... He's good at that. I'm going to go walk around the other side, though, and show everybody what it looks like.
You got it, Tim.
Ooh. You can't help but notice that this says Country Financial on it. And you could probably see that from a long ways away at any fair or event.
You can.
Uh-huh.
I highly encourage it.
Mm-hmm.
Bring props. Bring some fun things. Be fun. Have a grand time. Let me fix this part that my associate
might have missed.
Oops. Okay. So one of the things, obviously, is using the iPad. This is kind of where the magic happens with your backdrop. So it's important. They usually come in the cases, so make sure you take the case off. Otherwise, it looks like you never take a picture. All the passwords and everything you know are on the back, are taped to the cases. So if you need a password, you lock yourself out. It's not a big deal. The key is, obviously, if somebody's registered in the past, they could actually access that photo again. So I happen to be in the system, so I'm going to go ahead and say yes, and I'm going to go ahead and take myself a picture. By putting in the cell phone number of what you captured before, you can actually retrieve it. And I'm going to take a photo with it. The nice thing is I get to make some nice selections. I can be whisked away magically to Autzen Stadium. Mm. I can actually get to go do some to wine country, do a little wine tasting, or I can have a nice comfortable afternoon on the farm. Mm-hmm. I can take whatever picture I would like. Well, you know me, I'm a big fan of the Ducks, Tim. Mm-hmm. I'm going with Autzen Stadium.
Autzen Stadium, for sure.
So the nice thing is, look at how you can see the floor, but look at that backdrop. See how it comes into play? Yeah. The nice thing is I can move and zoom in any way I'd like to be in there. So obviously once I get in the picture, it's even better.
Right.
So you can make that thing look beautiful.
Very cool.
Yeah.
And then that gets texted directly to the person or emailed.
I can see my hands in there now. I can even picture my hand. Ooh, it's kind of nice.
Impressive.
It's kind of nice. So yes.
Very cool.
And Steve, that's how you do it.
Steve Such, thank you very much for your expertise in the future booth.
Hey, it's my pleasure, Tim.
All right. Go Ducks.
Go D2. And Ducks.